day after the BJP-PDP split, the president has also approved the imposition of governor's rule in Jammu and Kashmir, and that too with immediate effect. NN Vora chaired a meeting with senior officers of the administration and security forces in Srinagar. This will be the fourth time that NN Vora will be heading the state after his previous stints in the year of 2008, 2015 and 2016. The governor's term ends on the 28th of June, and sources suggest that the center just might extend his tenure considering his experience and given the present scenario in the state. However, the former chief minister of Jammu and Kashmir, Omar Abdullah, tweeted to say that the assembly should be dissolved immediately and that elections should be held at an appropriate time. Okay, and now it's over to Managing Editor India Today, Rahul Kanwal, who is speaking exclusively to the BJP General Secretary and the party's troubleshooter, Ram Madhav, a day after the BJP decided to pull the plug from the alliance with the PDP.
The unholy alliance between the BJP and the PDP is finally over. Where does Jammu and Kashmir go from here? Joining us live and exclusive on this special broadcast, the BJP's pointsman for Jammu and Kashmir, Party General Secretary, Senior BJP Leader Ram Madhav. Ram Madhav ji, welcome to India Today. It was you who fronted the BJP-PDP alliance, brought these two unlikely parties together. How much of a personal disappointment it is for you that the effort that you made to craft an alliance and to make these two, North Pole and South Pole, come together, that dream has now fallen apart?
Rahul, first of all, let me take strong objection to your phrase unholy alliance. You want to know what is unholy alliance? You should go and see in Karnataka. Two losers coming together, that is called unholy alliance. In this case, two parties which had the mandate came together. You can say we belong to two different ideologies, but if you study the Indian politics,
at last night on our broadcast, it was a BJP spokesperson. It was a BJP spokesperson, Ram Madhav ji, who called this an unholy alliance. Sambit Patra on our broadcast yesterday called this an unholy alliance. So it's not what I think of it personally, it's also what people in your own party
have called. Okay, you please convey to Mr. Sambit, you please convey to him also. You please convey to him also, or maybe he should also know that nobody can call any alliance unholy alliance after having living through it for 3 years. I will be very disturbed if somebody from my party had done it so, said it so. Having said it, there is nothing personal about it. When we put together this alliance also, it was the demand of that time. We had a mandate given in a very peculiar manner. We came together with the objective of giving a chance to peace and good governance to the state. We tried for 3 years. We succeeded to some extent, but we reached a point where, as I said yesterday, we found it no longer tenable to continue in this arrangement, and we felt the need for a governor's rule for a spell for some time, a spell of governor's rule. So that's why we decided that let us quit and give a chance to governor to improve the situation.
Sir, there'll be people in your party and those on the outside who say, ye toh hume pata hi tha, that the BJP-PDP alliance cannot work together, that since the time, you know, you yourself said yesterday that terrorism, violence, radicalization have risen and fundamental rights of citizens are under danger in the Kashmir Valley. Despite support from the central government, the PDP failed to control the situation. Was this an alliance that was doomed to fail from the first day? And do you now look back in retrospect and say, we maybe should not have done this, we did not succeed?
People can have different opinions. Humne to kaha hi tha, many people will say when something happens. Look, no alliance is easy. I asked those people who said humne to kaha hi tha, why did such a comfortable alliance of 1998 fell in 1 year? What prompted Jayalalitha and Jayalalitha's cohorts at that time to pull down the government of Vajpayee in 1999? See, every alliance has certain amount of uncertainty built into it. Whereas this particular alliance, although knowing well that we ideologically have different viewpoints, has come together in all political maturity, worked for 3 full years, tried to deliver on number of fronts. Some fronts it succeeded, some fronts it could not succeed fully. And I must tell you, Kashmir has seen much worse situations in the past. In the last 3 years under this government, we have neutralized highest number of terrorists, more than 600 of them. And you look at BJP's maturity. When a situation has come where you have to give up your own state government in order to protect the larger national interest, interest of the people of Jammu and Kashmir, we were ready in a moment to take that decision. You should go in BJP's credit not to criticize BJP for taking this decision.
So while you're quoting one set of data about the number of terrorists killed, can I also quote to you that just in the last 3 years, there's a 64% increase in terror incidents, over 800 terror incidents reported in the period up to 2017, up from 208 in 2015 to 342 in 2017. So the number of terror strikes, the number of our own jawans being killed, that has also gone up. It's not just the terrorists, the overall level of violence in Kashmir has gone up, sir, under your watch.
Look, you must read the history of Kashmir's terrorism since 1990. It has seen much worse phases. I'm not at all justifying any terror incident. Even if there is one incident, we will prefer that terrorism should end completely in the valley. But that cannot be held against the government. Government has gone actively after the terrorists. The security agencies have gone after terrorists in a big way, and that is the reason why there was an increased effort to increase terrorism in some parts of the valley, especially in South Kashmir. And everybody knows the role that Pakistan plays. And I must tell you, a large number of these incidents also include terrorists trying to sneak into India from across the LOC, getting neutralized on the border itself, on the line of control itself. See, it's a very complex subject. We have done extremely well in the last 3 months as far as neutralizing terrorists are concerned. But where we probably have not been able to do enough was that we have to simultaneously generate enough political activity in the valley, which we could not do. We had to engage with different sections of the people. There, the local political establishment should have come forward and done its bit. That was not happening. But on the contrary, political posturing was happening. You should talk with Pakistan. You should not have muscular policy. And, you should extend the suspension of operations. This kind of political posturing is where we felt that mismatch is growing. That is why when we decided that it's time we quit.
Sir, what was the last trigger? Was the killing of Sujat Bukhari, as has been reported, the final straw on this alliance's back? Why did you decide that now is the time? Because to my mind, the alliance was untenable from the first day, because you were North Pole, they were South Pole. I asked you this question when we met in Srinagar, the day your government was sworn in. At that time, my question was the same. It's the same question now. But what changed your evaluation? What, according to you, sir, was the last trigger?
For that untenability question, my answer is the same as I gave it to you 3 years ago, that we came together on a common agenda. On that agenda, we have been able to deliver a lot. In fact, Jammu and Kashmir's alliance in the last 3 years has been much more stable, much more coherent than our own alliances in some other states in the country. I don't want to name these states where we have everyday fighting with our partners. But we ran a stable, coherent coalition. But when it came to delivering on certain fronts, we felt that, I don't call it the last straw, but the last 1 month was a real test for us. When we announced the suspension of operations, which was wrongly described as ceasefire, during the period of suspension of operations, We had expected some kind of an activity, some reciprocation from some sections, some political activity. But when we found that not happening and the suspension of operations leading to further deterioration of the situation, wherein the freedom of speech also comes under threat, at peril, and a respected journalist like Shujaat Bukhari gets killed in broad daylight in the heart of Srinagar city, then we thought we should put an end to the suspension of operations, etc. But our partner wanted extension of suspension of operations. They called any other approach as muscular approach. You saw yesterday's statement. So there we found there is growing mismatch between two of us. Remember, we are not abandoning Kashmir. Instead, we are sacrificing our government in order to improve the situation in Kashmir, strengthening the India's national integrity. We are ready to sacrifice our government, and Governor Sood will certainly take forward the agenda that Government of India has set forth for Jammu and Kashmir.
Let me press you on this, Ram Madhav ji. What makes you think that a stint of governor's rule and an all-out military approach will be better than what we've seen so far? What gives you confidence that what you weren't able to do over 3 years with Mehbooba Mufti, the Indian Army and the CRPF will now be able to do for you?
That is your gross misunderstanding about governor's rule. Jammu and Kashmir government, when we put it in place, we had a four-pronged approach. Number one, we will go ruthlessly after the terrorist. The last terrorist in the valley will be neutralized. Number two, we will go after the overground support mechanism of the terrorists through legal means. Number three, we will try and engage with different sections of the society through dialogue. And number four, we work for the development and betterment of lives of the ordinary people in the state. It is a four-pronged approach. Work will be done on all the four fronts. It's not just militaristic approach. It's not just muscular approach. It's a humanitarian approach. It is an approach of engagement. It is an approach of legal remedy. And it is an approach through military security means. It is a four-pronged approach that governor, I am hoping, that will take forward.
Can you give us more detail about this? Because there are people watching in Kashmir who will be very concerned that those are the signals we've seen from some of your party spokespersons, some of whom you disagreed with as well, that this is an all-out green signal to the army, ab jaake thoko, find the terrorists, kill them. You're saying this is not an all-out military approach, that a humanitarian approach will be very much part of what the governor's rule will imply. Are you suggesting them that more conscious effort will be made to try and find stakeholders in Kashmir to whom you can talk to, that the aman ki asha, which at some time you held out, is not being abandoned?
Absolutely not being abandoned. If any of our spokespersons are saying that, then they're ignorant of the real situation. I'm sorry to say this, because I am really surprised that one of our spokespersons has called it an unholy alliance. Something that is blessed by Prime Minister and party president can be called unholy by our own spokesperson is unthinkable. So probably there is lack of understanding. The negotiations, the engagement with different sections, the developmental activity for which 80,000 crore package has been announced by Prime Minister Modi ji, all this will go on with much more vigor and much more fastness. They will be delivered quickly. At the same time, we will also tackle the problem of terrorism with an iron hand. Both will happen simultaneously.
I want to show you pictures, Ram Madhav ji, from Thral this morning. After an encounter, thousands of youngsters coming out protesting against the army's operations.
Rahul, I did
you go. have a problem trying to win over hearts and minds. How will you win over the hearts and minds of people in Kashmir, the youth who are picking up the stone? What's your government's plan to try and do that, Ram Madhav ji?
No, I know about what happened in Thral. Thral land order situation was very well managed. And the operation was also successful. Three terrorists were neutralized, and our engagement with different sections through the interlocutor Mr. Dineshwar Sharma is exclusively meant to win over hearts and minds of the people. And the developmental activity that we intend to undertake, that is also meant to win over the hearts and minds of the people. Remember, majority of the people of Kashmir Valley are firmly with India. There are forces, there are elements which are misled. It's our responsibility to bring them back to understand the reality. There are certain elements which are either inspired by local forces or forces external that are out to disturb peace in the valley. They will be dealt with firmly.
I have only a couple of more questions before I let you go, Ram Madhav ji. One, is there a plan to bring in a new governor into Jammu and Kashmir? Anand Vora's term, you know, his years get over on the 25th of June. Is there a plan to bring a new governor, sir?
I am not competent to answer that question.
Okay, how do you see Pakistan react to these maneuvers? Because you've got elections happening in Pakistan, the civilian government really in limbo.
Why should we bother?
No, I'm asking you about Pakistan's response, because Pakistan, even during, after the DGMOs reiterated the 2003 ceasefire, Pakistan was provoking us constantly. How do we, now that there's no BJP-PDP government in Kashmir, how will you deal with Pakistan, Ram Madhav ji?
Look, Rahul, we for one do not like Kashmir being hyphenated with Pakistan. Kashmir is an internal matter of India. There is a situation that government of India will deal with appropriately. There is no role whatsoever for Pakistan in that. If we ourselves start thinking what will Pakistan do, how Pakistan will react, then we are basically defeating our own purpose. As far as elections in Pakistan are concerned, we are also waiting and watching how the situation will unfold there, who will form the next government and what will be his approach to India-Pakistan relations. We will see. It's hypothetical now. We can't say anything.
Article 370 is one of the core aspects of BJP's agenda. For the last 3 years, it was on the back burner because there was an alliance with the PDP. Now that there is no PDP pulling you down, is the BJP going to reiterate its commitment to doing away with Article 370, Ram Madhav ji?
No, again, this question is always born out of gross lack of understanding. Article 370 is a matter for Indian Parliament to decide. Even if we have a government of BJP-PDP in Srinagar, if Parliament of India takes a decision on Article 370, BJP, if it is in tune with BJP's thinking, BJP has always held that Article 370 should go. That remains BJP's position, whether in power in Srinagar or not. But all that we said in our common agenda was that it's a matter for centre to decide. It's a matter for Parliament of India to decide. We two parties have different opinions on that, which we have admitted in our common agenda. Let us hold our positions, but as for the sake of running the government, let that not come in our way of forming the government. Because after all, it is not Jammu Kashmir Assembly which is going to decide about it first. It is going to be decided by Indian Parliament. And as far as BJP's position on Article 370 is concerned, I think it is crystal clear to everybody. It was frozen when Vajpayee was Prime Minister. When we ran a government for 5 years as NDA government, there were three issues. We never gave them up. But for the sake of running the government, because of the peculiar electoral alliance that we had to freeze those issues for some time. Even in this case, you look, we were ready to give up our government in 1 second in the larger national interest. If Parliament is ready to take a stand on 370, we would not have any hesitation to give up our government in Kashmir.
Sir, with respect, you said that this is a question born out of ignorance. It is not, because it was never really an active part of the legislative agenda of the BJP, because you had an alliance with the PDP and that government would have fallen had you tried to push this through. I think you've made an important point that this was frozen at the time of Vajpayee, and you're saying that as of now, there is no act.
Rahul, you are asking what?
Yes.
No, where is the question of Jammu and Kashmir Assembly talking about 370? It has to be taken up by Indian Parliament. Indian Parliament has to take a view on that. And you look at our agenda, we said very clearly that BJP has a different view on Article 370 than that of the PDP. We never said we are compromising.
Tell me this, Ram Madhavji, as you look back at the last 3 years, the highs and the lows, the ups and the downs, is there something that you reflect on in hindsight which you think, agar ye kiya hota, to shayad you would have had a better chance? Do you think Mufti Saab's passing away was also one of the turning points, and from there the alliance never really got its mojo back?
The alliance, in my opinion, was a historic one. We took the bold step of honoring the mandate and put together a difficult alliance. Mufti Saab had described it as South Pole and North Pole coming together. We ran it, it started on a rocky wicket, but then quickly it stabilized. But the real setback happened when Mufti Saab passed away just 11 months into the alliance government. We had a gap of 3 months, then we restored the government under Mehboobaji. And to give her due credit, for 2 full years, the alliance, it was a coherent, smooth alliance as far as the 2 parties in the state are concerned. The respective ministries, ministers of both sides, have been able to function normally without any day-to-day squabbles, any day-to-day troubles. On the larger issues like terrorism, how to tackle it, we had issues, we had differences. But day-to-day governance issues, both have worked very friendly, very closely together in a very coherent manner. That's why I said during the part of the interview that it was a much better coalition looking at some of the other coalitions we are running in the country. So I would say that while there were ups and lows, no alliance is easy. This also had its ups and downs, but it survived for 3 years. Somebody who was involved in putting it together, it gives me a little sadness. We could not complete the full term, but nevertheless, I have no regrets. Today, the time has come for us to take that final call, because larger national interest, larger interest of the people of Jammu and Kashmir is involved.
Ram Madhavji, in conclusion, when do you see elections happen in Jammu and Kashmir? And I'll tell you why I asked this question. Since 2016, we haven't been able to hold a bi-poll in Anantnag in Mehbooba Mufti's Lok Sabha constituency. The last time elections were held in a bi-poll, the voting percentage originally was 7%. In the re-poll that happened, the voting percentage came down to 2. On some polling booths, there were 0 votes cast. You are seeing the situation in Kashmir as closely as anyone in India at this time. Do you think it will be possible to hold elections in the foreseeable future, and when?
Right now the priority is for governor to work those 4 dimensions, and especially work on restoring peace in the troubled districts of South Kashmir. That is the utmost priority. That is the reason why we wanted a spell of governor's rule there. This assembly has a tenure until the early part of 2021. Let us see how situation unfolds. Whenever elections happen, we should go ahead and hold elections. Personally, I was not in favor of suspending or postponing the election of Anantnag at that time. The election commission should have gone ahead and held the elections in Anantnag. Now it is hypothetical to talk about it, but probably there could have been a bigger participation in the elections in Anantnag at that time than even Srinagar city. Srinagar city has registered close to 10%. Probably it could have been 15-20%. You must remember, in India, even Bangalore city registers 50% polling. So we should go ahead, hold elections on schedule so that people get confidence in the system. If we go on postponing elections, don't hold them on time, people lose faith in the system itself. But then who am I to suggest to election commission? They take their own decision about these things. I for one felt unhappy about not holding elections in Anantnag at that point. But right now, as I said, the priority is to bring back a good, strong governance in the state. Governor will focus on that. Then we will see how things unfold.
And what do you want to say to those outside the BJP who think, Ram Madhav ji, that this is an attempt to burnish your Hindutva credentials ahead of the 2019 elections? That the BJP-PDP alliance was dragging you down, now you don't have the PDP as baggage and therefore you can burnish your nationalist credentials, which with the PDP was always a problem.
No, why now? Cannot have any answer. I mean, you know, you are doing it to, you know, improve your chances in the parliament election. All this debate I was watching yesterday, this has no meaning. I said only consideration. I mean, I can tell you honestly, in none of at least my discussions with right from Prime Minister to Party President to Home Minister to NSA to everybody, not even once was any political consideration discussed. All the discussion was about how to improve the situation. Is the present arrangement tenable? Can we continue it or we should go for a spell of president's rule? So it was only with the larger national interest in mind that we took this decision. Had the other issues, political issues, been the real factor, we could have taken this decision much long ago. Why would we allow this kind of thing to continue for so long? There was criticism before also. So this time, only consideration was that we should improve the situation in the valley.
So you denied it at the beginning, but I sense through some of what you said a little bit of regret, and which is only natural given how much of your personal energies you invested in trying to make this alliance happen. It's only natural to not be very happy when it comes apart, but you're saying that the situation in Kashmir will improve on the back of this. As every right-thinking Indian, I too hope that that is indeed the case, because the situation on the ground is not in our interest. Winning the hearts and minds of people in Kashmir is
Rahul,
important. Yes?
In just a couple of months, you will see marked improvement in the situation. That's what we are hoping.
You know, and to our viewers, I want to say this. From all the things that Ram Madhav said on India Today, I think the most important is, don't assume that this will be an all-out military approach from now. The humanitarian approach will continue alongside. So that's the message I think the party's pointsman for Jammu and Kashmir sending out. I hope on the ground it translates into action, because if it does, it's very important. You can't win any battle. You can't solve any problem just through the gun. You have to talk to people over there. And that is equally an important part of trying to solve the problem in Kashmir. Thank you very much, Ram Madhav ji, for joining us on India Today.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.